So, as the third experiment, we are going to understand the utility of a basic building block made out of the op-amp, okay, which is called an integrator, or actually another one called differentiator. We have to find out which is superior in its application for building filters. Filters are essentially blocks which are improving the signal-to-noise ratio, so that you can further process the signal, okay, with the least effect from the noise. And such filters are built, are nothing but differential equations solved, essentially. And these differential equations can be either solved by using integrator as the building block or the differentiator as the building block. So we'll investigate which is superior in practice, either this or that. This is the integrator block. When Vi is applied, the current injected into the op-amp is Vi by R to its virtual ground, because this is held at zero, this also is very nearly zero. So the current in this is Vi by R, and that current is charging the capacitor and developing a voltage here, which is Vi by R into 1 over SC, and it is positive with respect and negative with respect to the ground. This is at 0 volts. So we have minus Vi by SCR as the output voltage. Here the R and C are interchanged, then the operation gets interchanged. Vi is driving a current in this, is which is Vi into SC, and that current flows through this R and develops a voltage which is minus SCR into Vi, and therefore it is differentiated. So now, because of the finite gain bandwidth product, these blocks are going to have their behavior changed, and that study is very important in deciding which building block is superior. And when we do that, it is the same thing, minus 1 by SCR divided 1 plus 1 over GL is the actual transfer function of the system. And if you substitute GL, which is the loop gain, which is gain of the op-amp, which is GB by S into SCR by 1 plus SCR. This is going to act in the loop like a high pass filter whose transfer function is this. And if you introduce this in this, you will see that this integration is having an error, and the magnitude error is controlled by this GB into CR, which is fixed. And the phase error is directly proportional to the frequency of the input signal. Okay, and it is a phase lag error, okay, which is omega by GB. And therefore, the phase error keeps on increasing as frequency increases. So instead of giving you the 90 degree phase shift, there will be a further lag of omega by GB approximately. Okay, for this you are going to study by obtaining the frequency plot of the integrator, its gain. There is one limitation, however. If it is used like this, a standalone integrator has a problem, because there is no DC feedback. Okay, there is this offset, which is typically in the case of op-amps about few millivolts. Okay, is going to be amplified by the DC gain, which is thousands or maybe hundreds of thousands, and therefore op-amp output is invariably in saturation. Okay, so in order to bring it out of saturation, you might have to put a high resistance in feedback, which will make it do not exactly the integration. It will be non-ideal integration. Again, the phase error is going to come into picture. So however, this particular differentiator, on the other hand, has DC feedback, and therefore automatically the output is going to stay at input offset, okay, which is very small, and you can therefore apply it. However, this has a disadvantage. As you see here, the transfer function now changes from minus SCR, which is the ideal, to a second order denominator, which is always indicated by the second order denominator we had seen in the sort of filters, etc., control systems also, can be represented as natural frequency omega naught there and omega naught in the Q. That means omega naught, the natural frequency of the system, that is equal to GB divided by R. and its Q is going to be omega naught into Q is equal to GB. Okay, so it is going to be GB into R. So that means it will start ringing. It is going to be a system which is underdamped and it will start ringing the moment there is a disturbance here. So whenever there is any disturbance outside, okay, even somebody starting a scooter, is going to cause a pickup voltage, a sudden change, and that will cause the output to ring at the natural frequency. This is a nuisance in a filter circuit that we have to wait until the output comes to steady state, and this you are going to examine by applying a square wave here. Okay, you should get impulses here, but you will get impulses with ringing. Right? If you feed a triangular wave, you get a square wave here with ringing riding over it. Okay, and the number of such ring peaks will be directly proportional to Q. Okay, so if Q is 10, it will be ringing almost 10 times before it comes to steady state. Now such problem is that this still remains as a first order system. Okay, as far as the denominator is concerned, and therefore this is going to only cause additional phase error, okay, in the response, and therefore this does integration fairly closely than this doing differentiation. So the integrator is having only the offset problem. However, this offset problem is not there in filter design because of overall positive negative feedback, and as far as this is concerned, because of this noise causing output to become very sensitive for the differentiator, these differentiators are never used in filter design. So we have rejected the differentiator, okay, on the basis of its poor performance, okay, for disturbances, and selected the integrator because it is sluggish for sudden disturbances, and it is quite convenient for us to use this as the basic building block, and therefore we will feed a triangular wave here also and see that it will be a parabolic wave here and without any disturbance, right? Whereas that we will have a triangular wave converted to a square wave with disturbance. Okay, further we will feed here as square wave and we can get a triangular wave. Okay, and you will measure the peak to peak value of the triangular wave and thereby determine the RC time constant of the integrator. So this experiment, and in addition to the frequency response of this, okay, now in order to obtain the frequency response of it, to prevent it from going to saturation, we will put a large resistance across it and then only obtain the frequency response of this, steady state frequency response, whereas there is no such trouble that is needed for obtaining the frequency response of this. The frequency of response of this, however, will be showing peaking, okay, because of the fact that it is not just differentiating, okay, and therefore it is going to behave like almost like a bandpass filter. So, and this peak depends upon the Q of the system. Okay. So essentially speaking, right, the frequency response of this should be just a line, okay, straight line going all the way, okay, indicating that the output is directly proportional to frequency. Because of finite gain bandwidth effect, it will have this kind of response. Right.